chin up, look far, raise your gaze. Like you said, aiming high, you see further ahead, you see construction, you see lanes ending, you see debris on the road potentially. As we approach, we have a green light. We're looking for the more important information, the walking symbol. We know the lights are fresh.
Yes.
Look left, right, left, and continue. Glance at the car to the right side, just a glance to say, hey, we're watching you, and to deter them from possibly doing something foolish or ignorant.
Yes.
We've got an e-bike coming up. Check your rearview mirror for me, Mandeep. Let's make a lane change to the left. Signal left, shoulder check, that's it. And in terms of technique for lane changing, Mandeep, when you can see tires in the rearview mirror and pavement, when you can see tires and pavement in the rear view, it means you have enough room to lane change.
Okay.
Three car lengths. If you see tires and a lot of pavement, you got a lot of room. But remember, you got to confirm your blind spot. And in most cases, we want you to accelerate with your lane changes.
Okay.
We only lane change to avoid the e-bike because of his pace or her pace.
Yes.
And as we pass the bike on the straightaway, potentially we'll look at lane changing back. Because the right lane is considered the driving lane and the left lane is considered the passing lane. So
okay.
If you can come over, check your rear view, put that right signal on, shoulder check, and accelerate a little bit as well. That's it, my brother. Well done. We'll proceed straight at the lights. They're green. We're looking for the symbol. It's kind of hard to pick out sometimes.
Yes.
I'm still looking for it myself. There, it's a walking symbol. We're fresh to go. Look, left, right, and we're gone.
Okay, good.
Again, looking up far ahead to where you're going to be, 12 to 15 seconds, so pretty much as far as you can see, targeting your path. So always remember, you drive where you look. And this goes for everybody across the board. You look at the curb too much, you'll go to the curb. This guy was going to maybe cut in, but he won't do it now because the guy lane changed, right?
Yes.
Always remember, if there's a space big enough to fill a car, people will try to fill it, right? And people accelerating or approaching, or almost look like tailgating, they make me lane changing. Here, these lights are pedestrian activated. If you see someone push that button, cover the brake, because the lights may go yellow quickly.
Okay.
We say that bend it, yeah, brake before the curve, lift off that brake, let your momentum carry you, your gas as you come out of the curve. So always brake before a curve, let your momentum carry you around the corner, your foot is over the brake in the beginning, foot slides to the gas. Pedestrian activated lights again, no one's pushing buttons, we're good to go. Peekaboo the rear view. So the expression I was gonna tell you is, it goes like this, and these are just some of my own creations. Gas won't save your ass, but the brake might give you a break. And then I'll say Kit Kat, because that's their slogan. Give me a break. Other ones we've come up with, you've heard it already, no vision, no decision.
Yes.
I love to use analogies. I always say we want Tai Chi, not UFC.
Mm-hmm.
Smooth, steady, gradual, fluid moving. Stop so you can see the tires and pavement again. So we've used that term two times, Mandy. We stop so we can see tires and pavement when it's typically a car. The bigger the vehicle, the bigger the space I encourage. So if it's a truck, you stay further back to try to retain your peripheral vision.
Okay.
If it's a bus, a London Transit bus, I leave the length of the bus in front. Why? So that if I choose to make a lane change around the bus, I have room within my lane to accelerate and come around. So you need a smaller window of opportunity. It has nothing to do with aggression, right?
Yes.
It has to do with technique.
Yes.
If you stop typically behind a bus, you have to pull out, then you get to accelerate. So you'll need a bigger window of opportunity.
Makes sense, yeah.
And also, we encourage everybody nowadays, because of distracted driving, that when you brake, check your rear view. You want to see, are the people paying attention behind you, or are they doing what I call hashtag the crotch watch, you know, looking at their phones, God forbid. Yeah, let them move off, count 1, 2, 3, create separation, right?
Yes.
And as you approach, look left, right, left quickly. You're looking for 1 in a million person running through a red light or stop sign. In the winter, they could be skidding because of the snow conditions. The road markings here are hard to see here in London because the quality of the paint is honestly garbage. Look far ahead to the lights up ahead. It's the main intersection in London, Wellington and Commissioners, and probably the widest as well. So you've got 3 lanes going straight, a left turn lane and a right turn lane as well. We can see the countdown timer is at 20 seconds plus, so we know we're good to go, potentially. And as you approach, glance left and right if you can, if you're comfortable doing so. That's it, my brother. Speed-wise, you're pretty solid, too. We encourage our students to stick within 5 over, 5 under of the limit in preparation for the road test, right? 10 over, to today's ministry standards, will probably get you failed on a road test.
Okay.
With rare exceptions. Now, We have the garbage truck, which is restricting our vision, which is not a big deal, but we want to keep our distance back, and potentially we do want to go around it at some point.
Yes.
Because we don't like the lack of vision, because you just don't know when they're going to break, what's going to happen. Look left, right as you go, minor intersections, so you don't have to move your head as much. And you peekaboo the rear view once again. If you've already done it, forgive me. Speed's excellent. The right lane is turning into a turning lane for cars exiting. So watch these cars to have a right signal on, or they're going to come over to our lane because their lane is ending. Because the lane ends at these traffic lights.
Yes. Yeah, like this car,
there's
yeah.
an overhead sign indicating that. It's a walking symbol. We know the lights are fresh. That's it, my brother. Pace-wise, always keep in mind covering your brake, because if you see them slowing down, that's it. If we do a good job of maintaining distance, when people brake, our first reaction typically is lift off the gas, right? Okay. If we're doing it right. Stage two is you cover the brake, and stage three is brake. But if we're following too closely, then you'll have to go to the brake right
yes.
away. And we're looking up ahead, eye lead time, targeting our intended path, and you're doing a great job. Way to go. Speed's great, lane position's excellent. Here we can see a sign, black and yellow, which is a warning sign, warning us that we have a fire station, not to block entrance or accessibility for the emergency services. The okay. road opens up again to more lanes, Mandeep. We'll continue to stick to this lane, because eventually it will narrow back to two lanes again. The right lane, again, because Wellington is a major commercial area, is basically an exit lane for all the businesses on Wellington Road. Once
okay.
again, as you slow, you check that rear view, my brother, and give this to guy time, and we'll roll up. Never use the gas when you don't have to. We really promote, I love to promote avoiding unnecessary braking. It's what I encourage all my kids to do. Challenge yourself to be very efficient with braking, acceleration, etc. If you do this, you're more fluid and you get better fuel economy as well.
Okay.
So a smart driver pushes the gas, not according to what he wants, because we all want to push, pushes according to what he needs.
Yes.
Based on his observation.